Welcome to the Maker's Pet Robot Bring Up Instructions video. In this video, we will power up the robot, connect it to Wi-Fi and the local PC, drive the robot around, create a map of your place, and have the robot self-drive itself using that map. Once finished, this home robot will act as a pet. Look cute, play ball, hide and seek and chase, entertain the owner, keep company, demand attention, and patrol the house. Please make sure that you have watched the previous video where we set up the local PC, including Docker and XLaunch, and uploaded Arduino firmware to the robot's microcontroller. First, let's launch robot software on your local PC. Let's make sure Docker is running and let's run XLaunch. Set the XLaunch display number to 0 and leave the rest of the settings at their default. The XLaunch dialog will close, but XLaunch will continue running in the Windows tray. Open the Windows Shell window and launch the Docker robot software image. Take your time to type the command correctly. Press the Enter key and you should get a Linux bash prompt. Now that we are inside the Docker container, let's launch the application that talks to the physical robot. The application will launch and wait for the robot to connect. Place the robot's base on a pedestal to let its wheels spin freely. Connect the battery cable to the ESP32 microcontroller board. The robot board in the video is a breadboard. I will replace it shortly with a proper custom-designed open-source PCB with a power on-off switch to simplify the bring-up. When you turn on the robot for the first time after the firmware upload, the blue LED light on the robot's ESP32 microcontroller should light up solid. This indicates that the robot is ready for its Wi-Fi connection to be configured. Open a new Windows Shell window on your local PC and type ipconfig and note the IPv4 address. Now, open your Wi-Fi manager and look for a Wi-Fi network named Maker's Pet. Once the Maker's Pet Wi-Fi shows up, connect to that Wi-Fi. Open a browser and navigate to 192.168.4.1. Enter the name and password of your Wi-Fi network. Enter your computer's IPv4 address and leave the last text box at its default. Click the blue Connect button. The robot's microcontroller will stop broadcasting the Maker's Pet Wi-Fi and attempt to connect to your Wi-Fi using the credentials you have just provided. Now, make sure your PC reconnects back to your Wi-Fi. Also, make sure that your Wi-Fi network is a 2.4 GHz network, not a 5 GHz network. Let's look at the robot's microcontroller blue LED light. We want the blue LED light to start blinking fast like this. Congratulations, you have connected your robot to your Wi-Fi and your local PC. The robot's microcontroller will store the credentials in its flash memory, so you don't have to repeat this Wi-Fi setup process again next time. Let me reassemble the robot's body and take the robot for a drive. I have powered up the robot again. The robot's microcontroller has successfully reconnected to the local PC, as you can see by the robot's fast blinking blue LED light. Open a new Windows Shell window and launch one more Docker Bash terminal. Inside the new Bash terminal, let's launch software to drive the robot manually using your computer's keyboard. Type the command as shown in the video. Press the W key on your computer to accelerate the robot forward. Press the space key to stop the robot. Press the X key to accelerate the robot backwards. Press the D key to make the robot turn right. Press the A key to make the robot turn left. Congratulations, now you can drive your robot manually. Now let's do something more advanced. Open the browser and navigate to the robot software GitHub main repository. Scroll down to the list of robot commands. Copy the Windows Shell command that opens a new Docker Linux Bash terminal and launch one more Docker Bash terminal. Go back to the browser and copy the command to monitor robot sensors. Paste the command at the Bash terminal prompt and press Enter. A ROS2 RVS viewer window should open. you should see your robot from the top with the red arrow indicating the robot's orientation. Zoom in using your mouse wheel. Pay attention to the white dots surrounding the robot. These are obstacles detected by your robot's laser distance sensor. Try placing a box next to your robot and see how the box will appear on the screen. Now try rolling a large ball around your robot. Thanks to the laser sensor, we can write software to make the robot play with toys like this. Close the RVS viewer window. Let's create a map of your place. Type the command on the screen at the Linux Bash terminal prompt to launch Google Cartographer, the software that makes a map using laser distance sensor data. Press Enter. Another ROS2 RVS viewer window should open. Go back to the window you used to drive your robot manually. Drive your robot around your place and watch your map appear as you drive. To create a good map, take your time and avoid speeding. Stop your robot periodically and make it spin around slowly to make the map crisp and clean. Once finished, open a new Windows Shell window, launch one more Docker Linux Bash terminal, and type the command on the screen to save the newly created map. You can also find this command on the kiCAD.ai main GitHub repository page. Close the RVS viewer window. Great! You and your Arduino robot have created a map of your place. Next, let's use this map to self-drive your robot. Type the command on the screen at the Bash terminal prompt to launch ROS2 navigation software. ROS2 RVS viewer window should open again, showing the map of your place converted to black and white. Click the 2D pose estimate button in the middle top of the window, then left-click and hold the location of the robot on the map. Drag the mouse in the direction where the robot is facing and release the mouse button. Click the Nav2 Goal button, then left-click and hold the robot's destination location. Drag the mouse in the direction you want the robot to face. Release the mouse button and watch your robot self-drive itself to its destination. On its way to the destination, the robot will go around unexpected obstacles as long as it can sense them and as long as there is enough room for the robot to proceed. Let's try navigation one more time. Awesome! Congratulations! You've got your Arduino robot self-drive like a professional-grade, incredibly expensive robot. Close the RVS viewer window. Let's shut down the robot software. Press Ctrl+C in each of the Docker Linux Bash terminals still running. At this point, I recommend saving your newly created map outside of the Docker container so you can reuse your map later. I will explain how to do this in a later video. For now, type exit at each bash prompt and press Enter to exit Docker back to the Windows shell.